am I?
Well, well, it appears as though the Prince of Slumber will be granting us an audience. How are you feeling, Your Highness?
Ugh, my head. I had a dream. I'm okay. Thanks for coming, Lydia.
You had us all on tender hooks. When I found you... My God, Daniel. I'm glad to see you awake.
Soph, I'm better. I'm fine. By the way, I found a note at the Husher House. It...
Daniel, the doctor said you need complete rest. Complete.
I'm fine, really. I found this. Apparently, Husher received a music box from an acquaintance of his, a certain Mr. Farber. It seems as though he was researching the music box when he vanished. And from what Farber says, the music box may be related to everything that has happened.
I'm not sure we should stick our nose into this business, after everything that's occurred.
She may be right, Daniel. I'm sure the police are very close to finding out where Husher is.
Do you think the police would have found me? We need to find Husher. I saw the box that Farber describes in this letter, but it wasn't really there. It was as if it were on the other side of... Oh. I think we should pay a visit to this Farber and ask him about the music box and Husher. He has a shop in the city, not far from here.
Daniel, please.
I'm fine, really. I think going to a shop and asking the owner a few questions falls within the range of what we can do, don't you?
Weird. It's not like Dad to leave the lights on after closing up.
Mm-mm.
Where did everyone go? Damn, I'm clumsy. Well, I could get that from the store using the basement stairs. What the hell? That door is reinforced with steel. I doubt I could hear anything on the other side. It's gone now. But how did it get in there in the first place? Here you are. Who? Good. Nope. Mm-mm. Ha ha! What the hell was that thing? I must be hallucinating. Huh. Somebody threw something away in the waste paper basket.
What the hell is going on? Run! Don't let it in! Damn, that was too close. Right. Oh.
Yes.
I had another nightmare last night. I was lying in bed and I felt something staring at me from the corner of the bedroom. I knew that there was something there, something very real, but I didn't dare turn on the light because I didn't want to see whatever it was. I was afraid of going mad if I did. So, perhaps in a rush of panic, courage or folly, I turned on the light and woke up. I got out of bed and went to the bathroom to wash my face, attempting to lift away the heavy feeling of something pressing on my chest. Then, I saw my reflection in the mirror. The face looking back at me was grotesque. It was deformed and changed color, and it was jolting about with despair. It was banging against the glass time and again, trying to warn me or to escape the place it was in. It seemed as if it was screaming, but I couldn't hear anything. The scene was so horrific that, well, I woke up again. I was inside the bathroom, standing before the shattered mirror.
I think I'm seeing things. Christ, something's wrong. Dad, where in the world have you gone?
is that? Voices? I feel like I'm being stalked. Better be careful.
I hope you are the one to find this, my daughter. I have had a few problems. Some sort of nightmares or visions. I don't know what to call them. I'm exhausted. I have a hard time falling asleep. And the doctor believes it's stress. But I suspect it's something else altogether. That blasted ox. Sebastian. Yes. You've got to find Husher. Sebastian Husher, the professor. My friend, or so he said. Find him and ask him how he did away with this. Ask him whether he also saw things. Ask him why he's abandoned me like this. Ask the black figure. Those who crawl do not want to see it. They crawl. The noise they make. No, don't ask. Don't get near. I can't sleep because of that noise. Because they dragged me away too. They're taking me. The black figure. I don't want to see it either. The figure. Please. Whatever you do, don't listen to the box.
The... Dream? Somebody wake me up already. The room is empty. I don't know what else I was expecting. Thank you.
Good. I don't remember leaving the lights on. Anyway, let's see how much of a mess the house was left in this time.
Thank you.
Dad, what the hell is this? Where are you?
Yes.
God, it couldn't hear me. Okay, let's see whether I'm able to follow the bloody trail.
I've got to block the door!
Holy crap. Am I going completely insane? It's close. I've got to hurry. There's a water. Yes. This is the wardrobe that Dad cleaned off in the courtyard. What's that tape doing here?
It's gone. The box isn't here. I've got it. I've had it all this time. How could it be possible? What the devil is happening to me? I have to get to my office. I must wrap it and send it to its owners. LeGrand Amsberg. They're the ones who... The office. I'm going to... I hear them crawling all over and screaming. Erica, come to my office.
Dad, I hope you're in the office and you're not... Dad! see if I can open it with this. Oh no. No! Dad! Dad!
There was Father. God. I don't even want to think about what must have happened in his final moments. As he was hanging from that noose with the bloody music box on the table next to him. I don't want to think about it, but somehow, very deep within me, I know the song was playing throughout his agony, stalking him to the very frontier between life and death. God. At least we had found the music box, and we knew where it came from. The Grant Amesburg Auction, it said, on the list of product lots, alongside an address. According to Husha, things had improved after returning the box to Faba. So by returning it to its owner, perhaps we might be able to solve all this. It sounded unlikely, but considering my hallucinations, the things we found at the antique shop and Mr. Faba's terrible end, if it could all come to some good, we had to try it. Isolated far from the world, in a holiday manor that must be about 100 years old, the lady who owned the sinister box awaited us. For my little Ariadne, read the engraving on the inside of the cover. Good. Good for her, then.
Do you think that someone could actually live in this place?
I don't know. The papers from the auction stated that the owner had sold most of her furniture, but that she still lived here. Mr. Grant? Hello? This place gives me the creeps. Hello? Are you Miss LeGrant? Ariadne LeGrant?
Amesburg?
Pardon me?
LeGrant Amesburg. It's hyphenated.
Oh, well, my name is Daniel Neuer, and I work for a publishing firm. Through a series of chance occurrences, I found something I believe is yours. It seems crazy, but when you listen to it...
That's its box.
No, I think it belongs to you. On the cover, it says...
I wasn't speaking to you. Thank you for bringing it back, Mr. Neuer. Have you listened to it?
Yes.
He has listened to it.
Oof. Damn.
Just what I was thinking. Let's get out of this place.
Absolutely. I'm glad we got rid of that thing.
Me too. I'm sorry it wasn't in time to...
I know. Thanks.
Come on. I'll take you to the shop. Thanks for letting me sleep here.
Of course. Whatever you need. I'll even let you sleep on the couch.
It's more than enough. I just need a couple of nights. That will suffice. I don't feel like staying in an empty house after everything that's gone on.
You can stay as long as you want. Seriously.
Thanks.
At least I know you won't drink my wine.
Very funny.
What?
Hey, Sophie?
Hold on.
Daniel, are you all right?